You know, the true definition of our worship is who we respond to. So worship does not end in a service like this. Worship walks right into how you respond to your everyday life. Jesus said, you can't serve two masters. That's why he said, in the same breath in Matthew chapter 6, he said, set your treasure on things above, not on earthly things. He said, for where the treasure of a man is, there his heart also is. Listen, God is not deceived. What you esteem the highest in your heart is what you worship. That's why the first commandment was, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one, and thou shalt love the Lord with all your heart. He said, I'm the Lord your God. You will have no other God beside me. You don't mix God. You desire him alone. And tonight as we sing the songs, can we help you tune your desires? It was in Colossians chapter 3 that Paul said, set your affection. It means if the affection is your own, you can set it. It's like a radio tuner. If I'm tired of 90.5, I'll go to, what's the other one? 96.1, Abby. Well, there are plenty. You know them. But it's a setting. If I'm tired of a channel, I set. It means that nothing should have the tyranny of controlling your life. You should get up and say, I love this thing. I hate this one. And that's how you are set above. That's how the government of God comes to you. Said, because you love righteousness and you hate wickedness. Therefore, the Lord your God has anointed you and set you above your fellows with the oil of gladness. So tonight, we want to declare that we desire nothing else. No one else.
I desire nothing else.
No one else.
No one else.
for the one I love. Say it one more time. Say the one I love.
The one I love is ever before.
Sails upon my heart. I live for the one I love. I respond to the one I love. I respond to the one I love. Oh, Zeda lo teka parondi ada basatad. Yeah, alabada. One more time, say the one.